Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Sharing Time Stories, Episode 58, Mike and the Coach. There are many railways on the island of Sodar. There's a Northwestern Railway, the Standard Gauge Primary, the Main Railway, the Scarlet Railway, which is Narrow Gauge, and the Arlesdale Railway, which is Minimum Gauge. One day, Mr. Fergus Duncan came to the sheds. The railway inspector's visiting. Oh, wow. Definitely not going to be you, Mike. That's going to be warm. Then Oliver came in with his auto coach train and stepped out the railway inspectors. There were two of them. They were twins. Hello. We are here and they inspect the railway.
Why aren't you taking the train?
Because there's been a test and it was better results when the inspector didn't take a public train. So we'll just take a train.
How about Bert pulls you since he always does it?
No, we want to pick ourselves. Thank you very much. Mike. Oh, yes! And that coach, too. Come on! You gotta be joking me, yo!
Oh, Mike, not so hot. Warning to pull the railway inspector now, said Rex and Bert.
He hated that coach. The coach's name was Annabelle. But everyone calls her just Anna. But Mike had no care. Actually, she was renamed Mr. Fergus Duncan after his sister, Laura. So the coach's name was Laura. The inspectors inspected the whole area. They inspected the barrel loader first. Meanwhile, Mike was going on his way around the turntable. Ow. There we go. He went to pick up trucks.
Why are you picking up trucks?
They need to demonstrate how it's worked. Thank you very much. Anyway, this COVID pandemic is also the reason why we don't take the train. Pleasure, we can see how everything works, too. It's way better. Yeah, the survey was better. It came out with better results for railway. Mr.
Fergus Duncan. Okay.
Now leave.
But Mr. Fergus came back. While they were doing the dynamite stand inspection.
Can you just be lying? Oh, sorry. Can you please
leave, Mr. Fixed? I was just checking how things are going. We don't want you here because we don't want you to give us a perspective on your robot. We don't want you to show us a good robot. We want to see the whole thing, good or bad. Okay.
Yes, please. Leave.
Okay, I was just checking. Oh, man. Mr. Fergus Duncan left. They went around then to the next station.
Don't overshoot the platform, Mike. No way, Laura. So Mike did overshoot the platform, but they were too busy paying attention to Bert that they didn't really pay attention to that Mike overshot the platform. So Mike went back.
I told you that you would overshoot the platform, but no one listens to me, especially not you. Yeah, who would?
But now then, see. Mike was really angry. Pretty good station. A+. They got back in Laura the coach, and they headed off to the ballast loader. First, they did a test on the turntable. The turntable tested well, and it went to the ballast loader. Mike went to demonstrate and got some ballast trucks, but he still kept Laura intact. The turntable turned, and then Mike coupled up back to Laura as they went on their way.
Oh, Tia.
Mike dropped off the ballast. Here you go. Thank you.
Oh my goodness, said Laura. Donald went away, and the inspector got back in. Laura, the coach, after inspected the station. But Mike was going too fast around the curve. Don't go too fast around the curve. You know what? Who cares? But luckily, nothing happened. I warned you. Well, nothing happened. Then they were going too fast around the curve when they went to go back to get the rail inspectors after they did it because they had to turn around on the turntable. Mike, then you rail Laura. Oh my goodness! Mike, well, if you haven't been so harsh, well, if you paid attention to what I told you. Mike helped Laura get back on the tracks. When Laura apologized and made Mike apologize too, the two were sad, but hoped they would. I bet you got a bad review, thanks to us. You may make us close. The rail inspector said, great job, A plus. What about Mike, said Bert. Did he do good? How did he do? I wasn't really paying attention. That's all you were supposed to do. I'll just give him an A plus. A plus for him. And the coach, they did the best. Mike knew what happened, but he didn't tell anyone.